Now then, I do a very warm welcome from me, David Hoyle, to yet another A Bit More Yorkshire Brass. Show number 136 this week in our online series began with Parade of the Charioteers by Miklos Rocha, played by the Travelsphere Holidays Band. That was from the 1959 film Ben-Hur, which starred Charlton Heston. Thanks as always for your requests, your dedications, observations, notifications, whatever you want to call them. We've got an absolute email bag full of them. In fact, so many, we are oversubscribed once again. I'm sorry if we don't get to your request as quickly as we perhaps did in the past, but we're getting more and more listeners to the show, and naturally more and more requests. Young Sam Dunn, our first march of the week is for you. This, as I say, is for Sam Dunn. Sam plays with the Friesland Band and sent me a request in for a couple of marches. We're going to play one of them this week for you, Sam. And this is an absolute cracker. Written by Kenneth Alford, played here by the Brickhouse and Rastrick Band, Army of the Nile. The Brickhouse and Rastrick Band playing Kenneth Alford's march, Army of the Nile, requested by Sam Dunn of the Friesland Band. Young Sam, email me, yorkshirebrass@gmail.com, with that particular request, as did Brian in nearby Saddleworth. The overture request I'm sending in, says Brian, is actually a test piece as well. We've seen that, haven't we, with the few overtures over the years, they've also become test pieces. Can I say that I played this one as the second section area test piece in 1982. I was on soprano cornet at the time, and it was a bit of a nightmare. It was a bit of hard work with some quite high work for me. I found it very strange if I may say so, that this became the final section test piece in section four in 2011. And when I heard that, I thought this is a bit hard for the fourth section, particularly on the poor old sop who's got all that to deal with. I can't say I liked the piece when I first played it, but I do like it now. I think there's a lot of good stuff in it. And then that's probably just a maturity thing. So anyway, Brian in Saddleworth, thank you very much for your request. The Grantham Colliery Band here playing the music of Ralph Vaughan Williams, the overture to Henry V. The overture to Henry V by Ralph Vaughan Williams was played for Brian in Saddleworth there by the Grindthorpe Colliery Band. This week's overture, as Brian quite rightly points out, has been used as a test piece on a number of occasions. A wedding anniversary coming up now, and this is for David and Joan. Happy 47th wedding anniversary to you both. David's been in touch to say Joan does everything for me. She's a brilliant cook, fabulous wife, and that we never have a wrong word. We were married back in 1975, and this was our song of the year at the time we got married, and we know that there is a trombone solo version of it. Please could you play Feelings by Maurice Albert on your show early December? Absolutely. This was arranged for brass band by Bill Geldard, and here to play it, Chris Jeans with the Virtuosi GUS Band. the great sound of Chris Jeans with the virtuosi GUS band playing Bill Geldard's arrangement of Maurice Albert's Feelings. Yes, it was in the charts in 1975, 47 years ago, when David and Joan got married. Happy wedding anniversary to you both from all of us at A Bit More Yorkshire Brass. Next up, we're going off to Harrogate, to Ian and Julia. We love this piece of music. It's mischievous, it's an audience pleaser, and it's a montage of tunes from the screen. The cartoon screen, says Ian. Thanks for all you do with the show, Ollie. We love it. My pleasure. I wouldn't do it if I didn't want to, absolutely. Here are the Whitburn Band, conducted by Andrew Duncan, with Andrew's arrangement, Cartoon Classics.
We'll be right back.
Cartoon Classics, an arrangement by Andrew Duncan. Andrew was conducting the Whitburn Band on that recording. That request was from Ian and Julia in Harrogate, who say, "We particularly like the bit at the end, eh? Abadee, abadee, abadee." Yeah, that one. We get it. Absolutely superb. Next up, we're into December already. We're going to do the festive stuff in a while. There's not loads of it, so the festive stuff will come later in the month. But on each programme, we're just going to dip our toe into some music which appears on some festive CDs, but isn't necessarily festive music. I want to play this piece for Joe and Pat in Huddersfield. You know who you are, and you know why I'm playing this. These particular plants appear at this time of year. They're absolutely beautiful, a lovely colour of red. This is music from the TV series Ground Force by Jim Parker, played by the Black Dyke Band. Poinsettia. Lovely. The Black Dyke Band playing the music of Jim Parker from the Ground Force CD, Poinsettia, for Joe and Pat in Huddersfield. What am I talking about this week? Well, I've received the list of new words for 2022. And new phrases. I have to say the new phrases was a bit disappointing. There wasn't much on it other than one thing, and I'm going to cover that off now straight away. Apparently a new phrase this year, and I've seen this. And I don't really understand why people use it, but you've got this, or you've got it. It means you can do it. Just say you can do it. You've got this. It's nonsense. Absolute nonsense. I'm going to follow up shortly, though, with some of these new words, which some of these are just so funny, it beggars belief, really. So we'll cover them off shortly. Now then, who have we got next? Do you have any music, says John, from any of the TV, police or detective shows? I used to like watching all of them. There aren't as many of them on now, but I can get them on the old sort of gold channels, says John. I'm going to play you a montage here, John. Let's see how many of these that you know. In fact, you know, all of you. Let's see how many of these you can get. I'll tell you after we've played the music, which shows are in here. There are five of them, just to let you know. This is the Leyland Band playing the music of Nigel Hess, arranged by Philip Littlemore for Brass Band. and this montage is called The TV Detectives.
Thank you.
Go on then, how many did you get? The TV Detectives, arranged by Philip Littlemore and Nigel Hess, made the original compositions of five pieces of music, which were fused together and played there by the Leyland Band. The five TV programmes were Dangerfield, Campion, Wycliffe, Maigret, and of course the most famous of the five, Hetty Wainthrop Investigates. That was played for John. I hope that tick boxes and brought back many memories for you, John. Thanks ever so much. Indeed. Another wedding anniversary, this time a 42nd wedding anniversary. Lots of long-serving couples on the show today. I love to see that. This is for Clive and Susan. They're in Ilkley, and this is music from the stage, actually from screen as well, because it's been done as a film on screen, but predominantly from the stage. And this is from Les Miserables, which is just wonderful. It's my mum's favourite play, stage show, whatever you want to call it. The music was written by Claude Michel Schoenberg, and it's played by the Brickhouse and Rastrick Band. Happy 42nd wedding anniversary to Clive and Susan in Ilkley, as we hear I Dreamed a Dream. Thank you. The Brickhouse and Rastrick Band playing the music of Claude Michel Schoenberg from Les Miserables, I Dreamed a Dream. We're celebrating the 42nd wedding anniversary next week of Clive and Susan, a lovely couple from Ilkley. Thanks for listening, both. Let's crack on to this list now. New for 22. It rhymes that, doesn't it? New for 22. All the words I'm going to read out over the remainder of the show have appeared in 2022. And I'm going to start with an irritating one for me, a finfluencer. A finfluencer. This is an influencer. Well, it turned me off straight away as soon as I see the word influencer. But an influencer who focuses on financial matters. Where did the word influencer come from? Anybody who's taken in by these people must be absolutely plain stupid. You make your own decisions in life. You don't need to listen to someone. I'm going on about social media again. But people who are on there and trying to point you down a certain track financial-wise. And then up comes the link, and of course from the link they are an associate, and by being an associate, if you open an account or take any finance or anything out, they'll get a kickback. They're just crafty people. They're not necessarily influencers, finfluencers, or whatever you want to call them. They're just after making a quick bob. But it's appeared in the dictionary, finfluencer, and so has this one, nomophobia. I absolutely giggled when I saw this. Nomophobia is the fear of being without or being unable to use your mobile phone. I'd love to be able to turn my mobile phone off and go out without it. I can't because I run a business and I need it for the business. But believe me, when I retire, the first thing I will do is go out without my phone in my pocket. We just, you know, you sit there, don't you? There's four people around the table and they're all on the phones. Waiting for the food to come. What's happened to the art of talking to each other? Is the world really so boring? Nomophobia. It should be described as frightened of missing something. That's what it is. People are just frightened of missing something or being the first to go on social media and tell the news that something's happened. God, nomophobia. And how about someone who is a sharent? And again, relates to social media, it kind of tells the times that we're in. This, a sharent, is a parent who uses social media to communicate a lot of information about their child. There is so much wrong with that. Where do I go with that? You know, keep it off there. Private information should not be there. And the last one of the first bit, a fitspiration. This is a person who serves as a motivator or motivation for someone to sustain or improve health and fitness. In other words, a fitness coach in the olden days, but now someone that you can watch on your phone. You get the gist, don't you, of where all these words are coming from. Our next piece of music, well, this is our heritage track of the week. Well, it's part of it anyway, Neil in Home Firth. Neil's been in touch to say, do you have a recording of Jolson Memories, the music of Al Jolson? I guess if you do, it will be on an LP. You guess correctly. Now, I can only play part of this because the first bit on the LP that I've got is actually damaged beyond me being able to play it on the show. So this is a part of Jolson Memories for Neil in Home Firth, and it's played by the St. Denis Band. Thank you. I used to play that in junior band. Jolson Memories. The music of Al Jolson was played there, or part of it anyway, by the St. Denis Band. The whole of the music was played by the St. Denis Band. We just couldn't bring you the whole recording, and I will endeavour to get a full replacement copy of that LP to try and get the whole of that played at some point in the future. Now then, a lovely message here from Donald. Donald is in Ayrshire in Scotland. I wonder if I can request this piece of music, which was written in memory of the Reverend of our old parish church in Dundonald. You certainly can. The Reverend was a champion of Gaelic culture and Gaelic music, and it made my day when I saw the music of John Mason appear on a CD by the Foden's Band. This is a euphonium solo played by Glyn Williams with Foden's, and Frodo Ridland made the arrangement for brass band. It sits perfectly in the quiet music slot, I think. You know, we normally have a quiet and reflective piece of music at this time in the show, and it certainly is reflective. This is called The Lament for the Reverend Archie Beaton. Excellent as always from Glyn Williams with the Foden's Band. Lament for the Reverend Archie Beaton. The music of John Mason was arranged for brass band by Frodo Ridland and requested by Donald, who is in Ayrshire in the Dundonald area where Archie Beaton was their local reverend. Let's get some more of these words before we go to the final piece in the first part of this week's A Bit More Yorkshire Brass, show number 136 with me, David Hoyle. Thanks for joining me. How about a Stan? Now, I would have thought Stan would have been in the dictionary, but it's probably just another meaning of the word Stan. Get this one. It's a combination of a stalker and a fan. Stan. It's a bit like spam. Are you a Stan? Do you stan anyone? Do you stalk them and are you a fan? If you do, then you need to look at yourself. Awesome sauce. What the devil's this mean? Apparently this just means extremely good or excellent. Well, just say so. Just say it's excellent. Oh, that's awesome sauce. I wonder where that might have come from. Now, the words low-key are on this list. Low-key, to me, for many years, has actually meant great, because anything that's low-key, I love it. Just get on with it, get it done, you know, and you don't have to tell everybody. But how about this sentence? I am low-key happy that band tonight was cancelled. What it really means is that I don't want to tell anybody else that I'm happy that tonight's rehearsal was cancelled, but I really am, because I have other things I need to catch up on. Low-key, a new meaning for that one. And finally, situationship. Now then, what does this mean? Well, this means this is two people who are more than friends, but less than a couple. In other words, they're in an uncommitted relationship. It's called a situationship. That's another new for 22 in the dictionary. Okay, we're going to end the first part of this week's programme with a cracking piece of music for Debbie. Debbie's from Malton, and she has chosen this Alan Catherall arrangement for brass band of music by Mick Jagger and Keith Richards. The Grimthorpe Colliery Band play Ruby Tuesday. Thank you. brilliant Ruby Tuesday, played there by the Grimethorpe Colliery Band. Alan Catherall's arrangement for brass band of music by Mick Jagger and Keith Richards for Debbie in Malton. Debbie sent that music request in via the Yorkshire Brass Facebook group. If you're not a member, go on Facebook, look for Yorkshire Brass and send us a request to join the group. The good thing about this group is it is just banding, and if anything appears, and some of the things appeared this week, you straight on to them, report the post, and I get it removed. We only want to talk about brass banding things on this group. That is what social media is about. Absolutely, 100%. What we're going to start the second part of the show with this week? Well, Steve and Vicky have been in touch to say, can you play this for our cousin Amy in California? We've been trying to get together since 2020. For obvious reasons, we've not managed it. But we've got our flights and arrangements booked to go and visit California next year. Is there a brass band arrangement of this particular piece of music, says Steve and Vicky? There is, and I'll tell you something, I played this the other week actually. Alan Ferney made the arrangement for brass band, and this recording is by the Leyland Band. It features the music of Neil Diamond, and it says exactly what Steve and Vicky are doing. Coming to America. Thank you. fabulous. The music of Neil Diamond, arranged for brass band by Alan Fernie and played by the Leyland Band. Coming to America, Steve and Vicky are telling cousin Amy in California that that's exactly what they're going to do in 2023 after a 3-year wait. John in Huddersfield is up next. I'm loving hearing the William Rimmer marches that we don't necessarily know or hear regularly. I wonder if you can choose another one for me, Oily, please. It's my birthday on the 6th of December. Well, have a great day, John. And this is another track from the Pemberton Old Wigan DW Band CD, which were all Rimmer marches. Hope you like this one. It's called The Cycle Parade. Thank you. Pemberton Old Wigan DW Band playing another of William Rimmer's lesser-known marches. That one was called The Cycle Parade, and it was for John in Huddersfield. John celebrating his birthday this week. Have a great day. And have a great day also to Diane Wibser. You, Flower, have got your birthday coming up this week. Big fan of the Black Dyke Band, followed them since the Black Dyke Mills days, and I wonder if you could play me any flugel solo by the band. But if you followed them for a long time, you will definitely know the name of David Pogson. David's a good friend of the show, a good friend of mine, and I thought we'd give this one a run out on this week's programme. The music is by Johnny Mandel and arranged for brass band by Dennis Wilby. David Pogson plays The Shadow of Your Smile. The sound is always and has always been wonderful. David Pogson with the Black Dyke Mills Band on the flugelhorn playing Johnny Mandel's music, The Shadow of Your Smile, which was arranged for brass band by Dennis Wilby. Back to this new for 22 list. Three more things off here. One of them is very surprising because it's been around for a while, but nevertheless, it's on the list. The first one is a metaverse. Here we go again. Modern day life. You can tell I don't like this universe that we live in. A digital universe where you can play, learn, shop, game, and more. I'll leave it at that. No, I won't. More, the more bit, it means annoy people, force opinion on people, or just make a general fool of yourself, in my book. Hangry, H-A-N-G-R-Y. This is not a London word, where the A replaces a U, but it does mean hungry, but it's a cross between hungry and angry. Hangry, so you're hungry and you're bad-tempered at the same time. I get that one. I think that's all right. And the last one on this bit, gig. I saw one coming. Someone came into our club the other week, actually, and came in and sort of sauntered in and went, "Hi, is there a gig on here tonight?" And our stewardess looked and said, "You what? Is there a gig?" We used to call it a turn in the day, but a gig. It's the posh word now, apparently. Right, next up, we are going to another one of these pieces of music, which is on a Christmas CD, played at this time of year, but it actually could be played at other times. This is written by Morten Lauridsen, and it features the City of Bradford band. Helen is in Bradford, knows the band well, and says, "I'd love to hear, at some point in December, the piece of music played on your show." The piece of music in question is called O Magnum Mysterium.
Thank you.
What a lovely piece of music that is. Helen in Bradford with that request. O Magnum Mysterium by Morten Lauridsen, played by the City of Bradford Band from their Christmas CD. Paul is in Trowbridge. He's been in touch. A regular listener to the programme, Oily, makes my week and keeps me sane. I like to listen while I'm in the bath. The trouble is the water goes cold, doesn't it, halfway through? Well, it does if you're in the bath for 2 hours, Paul. I'd like to hear the soprano cornet solo from the James Bond film Live and Let Die, if at all possible. Yes, this was written by Paul McCartney. A great piece of music to play. I've played bits of this as part of a three soprano feature that we once did at band, and came off very, very well indeed. This is played by Martin Irwin, a recording from the late 90s, but Martin is now back with the Brickhouse and Rastrick Band. Here we go, Paul in Trowbridge, your request, Live and Let Die. It's a great solo for soprano cornet, that, and a great person to play it to. Martin Irwin with the Brickhouse and Rastrick Band. The music of Paul McCartney from the James Bond film Live and Let Die. That was requested by Paul in Trowbridge. He emailed yorkshirebrass@gmail.com. You can do that too. Lots of you get in touch after each show and ask where the music came from and can you buy CDs. In some cases you still can, and if you can, we'll absolutely put you in touch with the recording label, or we'll tell you where you can find a copy directly with the band. Whatever the case is, if we can fix it, we'll fix it. Daz Clough in Leicestershire Hello to you, young man. Hope you're doing okay, and you've got the choice of this week's test piece. This is by George Lloyd, popular guy, a full CD at one point of the music of George Lloyd was made. Your request is to hear the Black Dyke Mills Band playing Evening Song. Here we go. The Black Dyke Mills Band playing this week's test piece by George Lloyd. That was called Evening Song, and it was requested via the Yorkshire Brass Facebook group by Daz Clough in Leicestershire. Thanks again, Daz, for that request. Now then, before we go to the hymn slot, let's clear off the rest of these things on the list of these words for 22. We have got B-Day. This is in the dictionary, and it's a shortened version of birthday. Really? So you're basically missing out a few letters and to put it in the dictionary. I thought a bidet was found in a posh bathroom. Well, that's another story. I like this one. This is the funniest word of the lot. Manspread. How about manspread? This is a man who sits in a public space or public transport wearing trousers, but nevertheless with his legs apart and taking up too much space. You can just see it, can't you? Spread your legs in a seat and in the hope that no one comes and sits by you. Manspread. That's a good word. And about this one, Froyo. F-R-O-Y-O. This is an American one. It's got to be. A frozen yoghurt. Bring me a Froyo from supermarket, will you? Two to go. Side-eye. I had a little wry smile when I read what the thing on this was. And it's actually written as such. Disapproval from your wife or partner by their eyes going sideways and a slightly downward tilting of the head. Oh, heck. That sounds familiar. That sounds really familiar. It's that look that says, oi. And I'm going to finish on this one. Corpargon. It's corporate jargon is the description of this. My description of it, if it was to go in a dictionary, would not get there. The word corporate would get there, but the second word would begin with a B and end in a T. I am just so thankful that I don't work in an office. I don't have to go through all this corporate jargon and box ticking anymore. You know what the second word is. It's to do with a big animal that lives in a field. What's the hymn tune this week? Well, it's the hymn slot, actually. Dino in Blackpool, not heard from you for a while. Lovely to hear from you again. Could you please play this music for me in the hymn tune slot? As it fits nicely, because you're almost going home. Hey, you know what? That's a really good shout, Dino. Yes, I am almost going home. We've got this piece. This is a penultimate and one more to go. This is played by the Dinnington Colliery Band from their CD, A Band for Britain, and it's the music of Antonín Dvořák. Dvořák's Largo from the New World Symphony.
Thank you.
The Dinnington Colliery Band playing the music of Antonin Dvorak from their CD A Band for Britain. Dvorak's Largo was played in the hymn tune slot for Dino in Blackpool. He says its alternative title is Going Home. Well, I won't be going home, of course, Dino, because I record this programme from my own studio at home. But I think it's an absolute brilliant idea that you came up with. And thanks for that. YorkshireBrass@gmail.com, the email address. For any requests, Yorkshire Brass, the Facebook group, of course, you can also send them into there. Please do bear in mind, we've got the festive programmes coming up. The requests may be 6, 7 or 8 weeks until they appear. If they are specific, day to get them in as quickly as you can. But we are recording now 3 or 4 weeks in advance, just to let you know. What are we finishing with today? Well, John in Halifax, I'd like a bit of Power and Passion, Oily, to finish one of your shows. This particular piece of music, says John, just blows the roof off. If it's played even at normal volume, my neighbour but three can hear it. It's that good. Yes, indeed. Thanks, John, for this one. The Black Dyke Band are playing us out today with the music of Charles-Marie Vidor. It's his symphony from Toccata No. 5, and as John in Halifax says, it's absolutely brilliant. Thanks again for listening. Back next week with a little bit more festivity in show 137. Ta-ra! Thank you.